I'm gonna start my pre-flight walk around. What I'll do is I'll start up here near the nose and just kind of check things over. Check the outflow valve right there. Check the ports. That's the equipment cooling vent. Check the antennas on the bottom. Check the negative pressure relief valves. Check the pitot covers. Those got to, or the static covers. Those got to be open. If they're not open, you can have some serious problems. Negative pressure relief vents. Ram air inlet for the packs. Just look and see that nothing's dented, nothing's broken. Everything's the way that in the state that it should be. Check the bottom of the airplane to see if there's any latches open. Check the wing. Give a quick look at the landing gear from the front. Check the back of the engine, make sure the latches are all closed. Making a movie. Yeah. Gotta check the bottom of the engine. Check all the latches. Make sure the thrust reverser latches are closed. Look in the back of the engine. Make sure there's no rocks, no birds, no homeless people. And I'll walk out the end of the wing. Just looking for general condition. Make sure the pressure relief valve is not popped in the fuel tank. That one, red one there. Check my lights. Lights are working. Static wicks. Those little pointy things that look like antennas. Those are static discharge wicks. Make sure none of those are broken off. That's the fuel jettison nozzle. If we have to jettison fuel for an emergency because we're too heavy, then that's where it would come out. It would just pump the fuel out into the air and let it evaporate. Give the landing gear a good walk around. Check the tires for cuts. Make sure the gear pins are removed. Otherwise, the landing gear won't retract when we take off. The gear pins are out. No tires cuts. Tires are all in good condition. Doors are closed, all the latches are latched. And I'll head back to the back. More latches to check. More latches here. Everything's in good shape. Antennas are alright. We're getting potable water service. That's for the showers and the toilets and the sinks. Got a rear outflow valve. I'll open it later. Latches. Check the condition of the horizontal stabilizer and the elevator. Looking right in the sun. It's kind of noisy back. It's kind of noisy back here. Check the vertical. Everything looks good back here. All the latches are closed. Ah, jet fuel smells good. There's the APU doors open. That's where the air goes in for the APU. APU is in that little compartment behind the pressure bulkhead. That's what's generating our power and our electric power and our pneumatic power right now. Now this whole horizontal stabilizer that we're looking at will move up and down to adjust the what's called the trim of the aircraft. So you can see that stainless steel strip, that's the range of motion that this entire tail horizontal will move up or down. And then in addition to that, the elevator control surface will move up and down for other adjustments. But when we're cruising or for takeoff and landing, depending on our weight and balance calculations, they'll set this elevator or this stabilizer into the configuration they want. That little round circle right there is a jacking point where if we need to jack the airplane for weighing or other purposes, is one point where a jack would go. This is the data plate. That's like your VIN, your vehicle identification number on a car. They keep it back here in the back because the back usually survives a crash. That's where all your black boxes and stuff are, is back here in the tail, because it's the last thing to hit the mountain. All right, we're taking on water. I said that already, didn't I? We'll check the cargo door. Check those green dots, make sure they're okay. If they're blown out, then we got a problem. Check more latches. Check for gear pins. Look at the condition of the landing gear, tires. And on the 777, we've got three trucks, and so this back one will actually steer. You can see that it rope pivots right here. That's a pivot point. It'll actually steer with that hydraulic cylinder. Will steer. Will cause it to turn in coordination with the nose gear. So when the nose gear turns right, when the nose gear turns to the right, these tires will turn to the left to bring the back end around and reduce scrubbing and dragging of the back tires, and helps the airplane be more maneuverable on the ground. If I didn't say it already, we check for gear pins back here, check for latches on the doors. We'll take a look at the trailing edge of the wing. Make sure everything's in, no major leaks or anything. We do get static leaks because we park a long time, so that's what those little streaks are, little static leaks that will drip down. They're not a concern at this point when they're at that small of a quantity. Check the pressure relief valve there. It's not popped out. Check our static wicks. Check our navigation lights. Red on the left, green on the right. I think the marine, that's the same way with the marine stuff. Red on the left, green on the right. Checking the leading edge, make sure that nothing's happened to it or been damaged or anything weird. Check the engine, make sure the latches are latched. Look in to make sure there's no obstruction. No stray cats. Check the bottom, make sure the latches are closed on the cowling. We don't want it to fly open at 600 miles an hour. Check the inlet, look for dents in case somebody's moved around and damaged it. Check the spinner, check the blades. Everything looks good in there, everything looks normal. We'll check the wing root inside the engine or inboard side of the engine. Latches are closed. That's the exhaust port where the leading edge, heated leading edge air exhausts. We get hot air from the engine, goes into the leading edge there, the silvery part, heats it up for melting ice, keep ice off there, and then it exhausts out, the hot air exhausts from there. All right, this ram air door is closed. We'll open that when we go back inside. Negative pressure relief vents. More static ports. Gotta make sure those are uncovered. You can actually crash an airplane if those are covered because you don't have any reference or any speed airspeed references, altitude references. This is our front cargo door. Make sure all the latches are closed. Check the bottom, check the latches. Is there a pitot system and our angle of attack indicators? Make sure the covers are off. The nose. Make sure it's in good shape. torpedo covers, angle of attack, outside air temperature probes. Make sure those are all uncovered. And make sure the landing gear pins are moved out of here. Gear pins, when we park, you gotta take them out when you leave, otherwise your gear won't come up. You have to come back and land, and it's more than an embarrassment. It can cost your job. All right, and then just look everything over. That's our lockout pin. When we're getting pushed back by the tug, they'll push that over and then put a pin down through the hole right there and lock that over. And that releases hydraulic pressure from the nose gear steering actuators, which are these big things. And that way they can move the wheel without causing any, without the hydraulic system of the airplane fighting them. And then when they get done, they disconnect the tug from the tow bar right there. They disconnect the tug, and they'll come and pull this pin out, and that pops back into normal operating position. Then we have control of it again. And the pilots control it with those two little cables right there from the cockpit and that little steering tiller. And that just pulls back and forth onto a valve in there that proportions hydraulic fluid so you can steer. Problems in the packs, but I blew those out yesterday. All right, now we'll check this backside or this final little area here. Check the crew oxygen discharge, make sure it's green. If it's popped for any reason, that'll be a red streamer that comes out. Can't miss it if you look. All right, now we're back to where we started, and the pre-flight walk around is finished. The airplane's in good shape.